Hello everyone and welcome to 2 Minute Tuesday Season 2, What's New in SolidWorks 2013. My name is Jimmy Barrera. I'm a SolidWorks Elite Application Engineer and I work with Cimquest. Today I'm going to show you a new sketch entity called a Conic Curve. Previous versions of SolidWorks, you can add a sketch ellipse or a parabola, but you could not sketch them by using their endpoints. For example, here, if I were to create a partial ellipse, I can easily pick the center and complete this curve. However, notice that I can change the center and I don't have tangent relationships added to this curve. So instead of using this type of sketch entity, I'm going to go into my commands and go into a conic. I'm going to quickly just add this to my menu so I can use it whenever I want. And as I click into it, I'm able to now create this curve using my endpoints. Notice that I can get the intersection here. If I tie my curve to this intersecting line, I ensure tangency to this side of the curve that's being highlighted. If I hover it over this intersection line, I ensure tangency in this area. But if I hover over the intersecting point, now I'm ensuring tangency from this new conic curve to the other two curves that are existing. After I do that, I can set the roll value. And notice that the roll value is what's going to determine if it's elliptical, parabolic, or hyperbolic. But more importantly, as you add these values, not only am I adding this curve, but I'm ensuring tangency all in one step. So as you can see in SolidWorks 2013, it gives you just one more tool to help you get the job done more efficiently by using conic curves and your sketch. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this session of 2 Minute Tuesdays. See you next week.